Hello, my dear students. Welcome to Methodist School Dankuni virtual classroom. As we are continuing the first chapter, representation of geographical features, today the topic for which I am going to teach today, the measurement of distance on the topographical map. So, in the last episode, we have already mentioned the scale of the map, and I mentioned to you also that the scale of the map of a toposheet is 2 cm to 1 km. That means 2 cm on the map is equivalent to 1 km on the ground surface. So there are basically two methods what we are using to measure the distance on a topographical map. So first method is direct distance method, which is also known as shortest distance method, which is also called as stone's throw distance or crow flight distance. So remember, these all four names are same only, like names are different, but methods of measurement will be different. As I mentioned to you earlier, that this direct distance method is measured with the help of ruler. So with the help of ruler in centimeter unit, we will measure the direct distance. Now let us come to the indirect distance. Indirect distance, which is also called as route distance. This route distance is basically measured along the roadways, along the canal, along the bank of the river, alright. And this indirect distance is measured with the help of thread or string. So this video only I am going to discuss about the types of settlement pattern. So before going to the description of different types of pattern, let me tell you, what do you mean by the word pattern? Pattern simply means geometrical shape. So a pattern must have a definite shape. So let us come to the first topic. See, the nucleated settlement pattern. So what is given? Settlements are found in clusters. They are compact and concentrated. And there are various factors which are responsible for the development of nucleated settlement pattern. What are the factors? Level relief, that means plain land. Next is fertile soil, then favorable climatic conditions, then well-developed transportation network. So all these factors leads to the development of nucleated settlement pattern. Let us come to the diagram. Now look at the diagram. You see that settlement blocks are found in clusters. Alright, settlement blocks are found in clusters, and see, they are compact. And you see that generally, this type of settlement is found at the junction point of roadways. You see the different types of roadways are coming from different portion. And here is a meeting point. And see, settlements are clusters and compact. Now, let us come to the next settlement pattern. Next settlement pattern is given. See, linear settlement pattern. Alright. So, what is a linear settlement pattern? You see that linear settlement patterns are found, or it's stretched out along the local main road, along the road, that means river bank, railway line, coast, that means coastline. You see, there is a roadway. You see, along the roadway, the settlements are found. And the third one, dispersed or scattered settlement pattern. The word itself, you can make out that settlements are found in haphazard manner or isolated manner. So you see the diagram. Settlements are not compact, or they are not found in clusters. Rather, they are haphazard. They are found here and there. They are not found in cluster format. So what are the factors that are responsible for dispersed settlement pattern? First is infertile soil. Second is adverse climatic condition. Third is mountainous topography or hilly topography. And fourth is dense vegetation cover. So these are the factors which are contributing for the development of dispersed settlement pattern. In the, what you call, in the hilly regions of northeastern states, in the Himalayan mountain region, you will find dispersed settlement pattern. If you go to the Gangetic West Bengal, you will find nucleated settlement pattern. Alright. So these are the three different types of settlement pattern you have to do. Please do comment in the comment section box of the video if you have any doubt, and I'll try my level best to give the answer. of your question. Thank you so much.